This is an example of kinky demand curve model, which is an example of a non-cooperative oligopoly. Let's assume that we have only two firms, which we can call a duopoly, and firm one decided to decrease its price. Therefore, its rival, its competitor firm two, will have to follow the same strategy by decreasing the price, because firm two will be afraid that customers will leave firm two and go to firm one. Therefore, when firm two follows the same strategy and decrease the price, they will end up with each firm maintaining the same number of customers. Consequently, what will happen to the total revenue for firm one? Total revenue will decrease because now they sell at lower price and same quantity. So we know that when firm one decreases the price, its total revenue will decrease, which means the relationship between the price and total revenue is a positive relationship. We know that based on elasticity, when we have a positive relationship between price and total revenue, this means that this type of elasticity is called inelastic. So we know that our demand curve for firm A will be inelastic. So when we draw it, it will be steeper or flatter? It will be steep. Therefore, we will give it label as D1. Therefore, this is our x-axis, which is the quantity, our y-axis is the price, and we will draw a steeper demand curve and we'll call it D1. Then, what if firm 1 decided to do the opposite, increase the price? So if firm 1 increased the price, so customers will leave firm 1 and go to firm 2 because firm 2 is cheaper. Therefore, firm 2 will not follow the strategy. They are not going to react because they will be better off. Consequently, if firm 1 increased the price and their customers move to firm 2, what will happen to the total revenue for firm 1? Total revenue will decrease. So this means that now, for firm 1, it has higher price and lower total revenue. What is the relationship here? It's negative relationship between price and total revenue. Based on elasticity, we know that our demand curve is elastic because we have a negative relationship between price and total revenue. So if we have elastic demand curve and I would like to draw it, it will be steeper or flatter? It will be flatter. And I will give it symbol D2 and its color will be blue. So we will draw a flatter line and this is our D2. Therefore, based on this anatomy, you will discover that anytime we have oligopoly, it's better that to compete with any other factor except than the price. Because if you started to play with the price by decreasing the price, it would result in a price war between these two firms, and both firms will be worse off. Therefore, it's better that to compete using any other strategy away from the price. So you will discover that here, our demand curve 1 and demand curve 2 intersect at this point. And this will give us here a certain quantity and a certain price here, B star. So we know that at a lower price, the demand curve is what? Inelastic, which means steeper. And at a higher price, the demand curve is elastic, is flatter. Therefore, at a higher price, I will choose the part of the flatter curve. And then at a lower price, I will choose part of the demand curve, which is inelastic, which is steeper. And that's why we call it kinky demand curve. Why? Because the demand curve will be broken at this point. And this will be our demand curve, which is the white curve that's kinked at this point. Then we'll draw here our marginal revenue. This is marginal revenue 2 and this marginal revenue 1. And discover that our marginal revenue is discontinued at a certain price. Why it's discontinued? Because our demand curve is kinked, is broken. And this is our marginal cost. So you'll discover that our profit maximizing condition is marginal revenue is equal to marginal cost. But here we have a discontinuity in marginal revenue, which means if the marginal cost increases, but it is still within the discontinuity of marginal revenue, we don't need to change our price, which means we don't need to change our quantity.